If you're moving from a warmer climate to Boston, your main concern might be the cold winters. How cold does it get in Boston? How long the winters are? Can I survive it? Can I do anything during winter months? I'm going to give you 10 tips on how you can not only survive the winter, but to enjoy it. This is Nuneh and the Greater Boston Real Estate Show.
Nuneh's Greater Boston Real Estate Show.
Usually we do not have a lot of snowfall in November through December. The temperatures are in high 30s, low 40s. The same thing happened this year. We had a couple of snowstorms in December, but then in January it started snowing, one snowstorm after another. Usually March weather is summer one day, it's really hot, everybody wears shorts, and then winter comes the next day. But by the end of May, you can definitely store your winter jacket. Number one, when planning to move to Boston, first make sure you rent or buy a place that has snow cleaning services. It will make your transition a little bit easier. Buy a house with a garage, carport, or hire a plowing service. If that's not an option, then you have to plan extra 15 minutes in the mornings to clean your car. A simple device can cut that time in half. You first warm up the car and clean the snow from other places, and at the end you just take this off and there is no need to scrape the windshield. It's very inexpensive and very convenient. I included the link in the description box below. To de-ice your car, you can fill a water bottle with windshield wiper fluid and spray it before clearing the snow and ice from your car. If you will be using public transportation a lot, that means you'll be out a lot. Thermal underwear is a must. If you don't have thermal underwear, just wear layers. Make sure to wear wool leggings under those jeans. Merino wool hats and socks will keep you not only warm, but if you get into a puddle and your socks get wet, merino wool will dry out fast. It can absorb 30% of its weight worth of moisture. It's a great insulator. Tip number three, get warm gloves. They are a must, especially the ones with the touch screen points. The hands can get frozen in minutes when you try to text someone. Please hit the like button if you're enjoying this video. Tip number four, insulated goose feather coats and waterproof boots. That's also a must. Go for insulated coats that are lightweight and waterproof and can protect you in temperatures below zero. And go for down coats. They have the best heat retention and make sure they're waterproof as well. I would recommend to have at least two coats, one for formal occasion made of fabric and one extra long, extra warm coat. What kind of boots you should get? The snow eventually becomes slush and a lot of times we have freezing rain. So go for boots that are waterproof, they're extra warm and that have non-slip soles. Tip number five, learn how to deal with darkness. From mid-November to about February 1st, it gets dark at around 4 p.m. This is what most Massachusetts residents complain about. It's not the cold that gets us, it's the darkness. If you're working from 9 to 5, you might, and you don't have any windows in your office, it can get extremely depressing because you get to work, it's 7 a.m. it's dark, you get out at 5 p.m. it's dark. Vitamin D usually helps, but also what helps, you can get one of those inexpensive lights that are for seasonal depression. They are very effective. I use it myself. If you're working from home or have many windows in your office or your school, you should be okay because Boston winters are surprisingly sunny from like 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. We get a lot of sun. Tip number six, enjoy winter outdoor activities. Make sure to participate in as many winter sports as possible and spend as much time outdoors as possible. There are many ski slopes around Boston. If you can't downhill ski and can't do cross-country skiing, snowshoeing or skating is also great. Skiing places have snowshoeing rentals as well. Skating is very popular among young people and every town around Boston has a skating rink. There's also Frog Pond in downtown Boston where people can rent skates and skate outdoors. If you are coming from a warm climate and you never had any experience with winter sports, snowshoeing is your best bet. Tip number 9, when it gets really cold, people start to feel like hibernating inside. It's too cold to go to a theater, restaurants, meet friends, or go to movies. Force yourself to do those things. You'll be much happier. And tip number 10, find the things you love about winter. The first snowfall is beautiful. Everything is clean, soft, and silent. The world stops for a moment. The world turns into a magical white kingdom from one of those fairy tales. If you're moving to Massachusetts and would like to know more, schedule a Zoom call with me using the link provided in the description box below and watch my other videos. This is Nune and the Greater Boston Real Estate Show.